Hi everyone and welcome. In this video, we're going to do a bit of prep work on our infrastructure virtual machine to support vCenter server. And what we're going to do specifically is create an Active Directory domain and add some DNS records. I already have a remote desktop session into my infrastructure VM. Going to pull up Server Manager, select local server. We can see right now we're in a work group. So in manage, I'm going to add role and feature, get rid of this page since we don't need it. Should let me maximize this. It's going to be role based. We're going to install on this host and I'm going to install Active Directory domain services. We'll add the features so we get the management tools. Click on next and next. And next, and install. We don't need to reboot yet. And once the role is installed, we will promote this machine to be a domain controller. I'm going to pause the video while we're waiting for the installation to take place, and then we'll come back. Okay, our role is now installed. We have to promote the server to a domain controller, which launches the Active Directory domain services configuration wizard. I'm going to create a new forest. The root domain is going to be vclass.local. We are definitely going to add DNS services and global catalog. Forest and domain functional level of server 2016 is fine. You have to put a recovery password. We cannot create a DNS delegation since there is no parent domain. This will determine that our NetBIOS domain name is going to be vClass once it finishes scanning the network. There we go. The default location for all of the files is going to be fine. And we are good. We'll do a prerequisite check, which is going to have a few warnings on it because of the functional level, and that's fine. Once it's finished with that, we'll go ahead and install. Okay, this is doing the installation. Once this is finished, it's going to automatically reboot. This is going to take a few minutes, so I will pause the video and we'll come back once the system's rebooted. Okay, we are back with the server rebooted. If I select local server, we'll be able to see that we're no longer in a work group. We're now in the vclass.local domain. The only thing we have to do to finish doing preparation is create some DNS records. So I'll pull up the DNS management tool. Select my server. First thing I'm going to do is create a reverse lookup zone for the subnet that all of these hosts are on. So just right-click this. Oops. Just select it first. Right-click new zone. This is going to be primary. We're going to store it with Active Directory. We'll replicate to all the DNS servers in the domain. We only have one. It doesn't really matter. It will be IPv4 reverse lookup. Put in the network address. We are not going to have any dynamic updates, so it doesn't really matter. And we'll finish. So here is my reverse lookup zone. And then in the vClass local domain, we need to create both forward and reverse lookup records for both Esxi hosts and VCSA. So I'm going to right click in here, say I want a new host record. This will be Esxi 01202. Going to create a pointer record while we're at it. So that's created. We'll do Esxi 02. 203 and create the reverse lookup. And we're also going to do the CSA. We haven't created that yet, but we're going to do that next, and we need DNS working for that. And we'll put in the IP address that will be configured on the CSA. Okay, so all three forward lookup records are created, ESXi012 and VCSA, with the correct IP addresses. Going to look at my reverse lookup zone and make sure I've also got reverse lookup for ESXi 1 and 2 and VCSA with the correct IP addresses. Make sure that you check these before you finish up this part of your lab. If you have messed up on anything with the DNS records, you are going to have some problems in the future, and you'll have to go back and do some troubleshooting at that point in time. That is a wrap for this video. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.